It's AumSum time!
Why do our ears hurt when we fly?
Because they play heavy rock music in flight.
Oh, AumSum. Let me explain. When sound waves enter our ear, they make our eardrum vibrate and are eventually interpreted as sounds by our brain. Our eardrum is located between the ear canal and the middle ear. The air present in both these areas can affect the position of our eardrum. Now, before we take off, the air pressure in the ear canal and the middle ear is the same. When the flight begins to take off, the air pressure in the airplane and thus the ear canal begins to drop. Now, due to higher air pressure in the middle ear, our eardrum is pushed outwards, causing us pain. Similarly, the opposite happens while landing. Our eardrum is pushed inwards, again causing us pain. Are earphones harmful?
No, they make us look cool.
Oh, listen. When any sound wave enters our ear, it creates vibrations in our eardrum. These vibrations then travel through tiny bones and eventually get transmitted to cochlea. Cochlea is a fluid-filled chamber with tiny hair cells. Now these vibrations move the fluid as well as the hair cells, allowing us to hear. Now, as earphones are very close to our eardrums, continuous loud music causes extreme movement of the hair cells, thus decreasing their sensitivity over time, eventually leading to hearing loss. Now, some solutions. Firstly, we can hear better quality music at a lower volume level with noise-canceling earphones as they remove unwanted background sounds. Secondly, some experts recommend the 60x60 rule. One should listen to music at 60% volume for a maximum of 60 minutes. Thirdly, over-the-ear headphones are recommended as they are further away from our eardrums. What is earwax?
It is a wax used to make candles.
Oh, gross. Not at all. Earwax is used to lubricate and protect our ear canal, middle ear, and inner ear.
Oh, but how does it form?
Our ear canal consists of special glands. They produce an oily and waxy substance called cerumen. Cerumen moisturizes our ears. It traps dust and dead skin cells, keeping our ears clean. Besides this, cerumen also has antibacterial properties. When harmful microbes try to enter deeper into our ears, the cerumen traps and kills the microbes. These dead microbes, dust, oil, and dead skin cells together form the earwax. Topic: ear. How do ears help with balancing? They really do. You don't believe me. Okay, can you play guitar and walk at the same time? How do you think you are able to maintain your balance? Do you know why you can't balance yourself anymore? Wait, I will tell you. This happens because there is a connection between our ears and body balance. Our ear consists of three parts: outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. Our inner ear works in sync with our eyes and muscles, helping us maintain balance while we are doing various activities. The inner ear consists of three semicircular canals called superior semicircular canal, posterior semicircular canal, and a lateral semicircular canal. The three semicircular canals are arranged in three different positions. Each of these canals has a fluid called endolymph and hair cells called cilia at the base. Whenever we move our head, the fluid moves, resulting in the movement of the cilia as well. When the cilia moves, it sends signals to the brain informing which direction our head has just moved in. Each canal has different functions as per the movement of our head.
Hooray!
When we move our head up and down, the superior semicircular canal helps our brain to understand the yes motion. When we tilt our head towards our shoulders, the posterior semicircular canal helps our brain to understand the tilting motion. When we move our head from side to side, the lateral semicircular canal helps our brain to understand the no motion. It was too complicated, right? Okay, don't worry about it. Relax. Why don't you go on a merry-go-ride? Hey, why were you not able to maintain your balance? This is because when you sat in the merry-go-round and started rotating, the fluid in the semicircular canals also started to move. After a while, it was moving at the same rate at which you were moving. However, when the ride stopped and you got down from the ride, the fluid was still in motion due to inertia. Hence, even though you were not moving, the moving fluid gave your brain false information telling you that you are still in motion. Thus, you were not able to maintain your balance.